Should we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me check. Hello? भाई मैं कह रही हूँ कि मुझे आप एक को वो कर दो, ठीक है, डिलीट कर दो, मुझे पता नहीं। हाँ भाई मैं कह रही हूँ कि इको है शायद, एक को डिलीट कर दो। ओके थैंक यू। अब मुझे नहीं पता, मैंने शायद एक ब्राउजर में किया हुआ है और एक माइक्रोसॉफ्ट टीम में किया हुआ है, देखो, या फिर मुझे देखो, मैं देखती हूँ एक बार, टीम वाला मैं डिस्कनेक्ट करती हूँ।
Yes, ma'am. Now it is fine, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes. I think today's topic is GARCH models. As per schedule, yes, as per program schedule, we have covered on first day basic concepts of econometrics, yesterday ARDL model, today is conditional heterostochastic models using eViews and R software. R software we will be touching for conditional heterostochasticity tomorrow, to some extent it will be touched today. Only basic models with R we will be covering today. Only basic GARCH 1-1 model, other models we will be covering tomorrow. Yes. What is heterostochasticity? Yes, I told you day before yesterday, what is heterostochasticity?
Unequal variance.
It is unequal the variance in the error term.
When variance in the error term, again?
It is different. I mean, it is not the same. That is known
when
as the variance
in the error term increases with the increase of value of independent variable, it is called heterostochasticity. It was same we are discussing.
Yes, ma'am.
It was same. Variance should be same for all values of x. I'm sharing my screen, the same window. My screen is visible. Yes, see, it was heterostochasticity. In the upper diagram, variance was same with the increasing values of x. But in lower diagram, variance is increasing with the increasing values of x. Variance of residuals. Clear? It is heterostochasticity, but we are talking about ARCH models, conditional heterostochasticity. When instead of x, we plot time on x-axis, then it will be called ARCH effect. My point is clear? My point is clear.
Please repeat, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. If variance in residuals is increasing with the increasing values of x variable, independent variable, it is called heteroscedasticity. Clear? Then what is ARCH? Autoregressive conditional heteroscedasticity. What is conditional and what is unconditional? What is conditional and what is unconditional?
Ma'am, when the study is means conducted based on some given information, on some prior work, it is conditional.
Yes, there is some question from yesterday's session. Yes, ask question, then we will be moving forward. In chat, there is a message. I want to ask a question regarding yesterday's session. Yes. Okay. I think there is some issue. Yes. What is conditional? Conditional means conditional on the past values of previous values of a variable. Clear? It is conditional. Means we know we have some information, and on the basis of that information, we are deciding the future value. It is conditional. Future value or present value, it is conditional. But without any information, we are calculating some value, it is unconditional. We are calculating the mean without estimating other values, without knowing about other values, it is unconditional. When we are calculating the mean for today on the basis of information that is available up to yesterday, then it is conditional mean. My point is clear? My point is clear? What is conditional mean? In time series, conditional mean means we are calculating mean for today on the basis of information available up to yesterday. It is conditional mean. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Same. Yes, ma'am. What is conditional variance? We are calculating variance based for today on the basis of information available up to yesterday. It is conditional variance. Clear? It is conditional heteroscedasticity. Variance means heteroscedasticity. When variance is homoscedasticity, means variance is same for all the values of X or for all the values of time period. It is homoscedasticity. And heteroscedasticity, what is heteroscedasticity?
Then the variance changes with the change.
Means variance changes with time. What is ARCH effect? Conditional heteroscedasticity means it is changing with time. What is ARCH effect? It is dependent on its previous value. If previous value was positive, present value will be positive. If previous value was negative, present value will be negative. Am I right or wrong? I am wrong. But what is this wrong? What is wrong in my statement? I'm saying if previous value was negative, present value will be negative. If previous value was positive, present value will be positive. What is wrong in this statement? We are talking about variance. We are talking about variance, and variance may be only positive. Variance may be only positive, no negative variance. Clear? Means if previous value was less, then present value will be less than a specified value. If previous value was high, then present value will be high. Clear? It is AR effect, means present value depends on the previous value, just like in mean, just like in variance. Clear? Up to yesterday, when we were talking about simple regression or ARDL model, we were talking about average value of variable. We were not interested in heteroscedasticity, but today we want to model mean as well as variance. Up to yesterday's sessions, we were interested only in mean value of the variable, but today we are interested in mean as well as variance. Point is clear up to now? Point is clear up to now or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. How to, in the important points I shared with you, there is a point that if there is heteroscedasticity and you want to model it, there is conditional heteroscedasticity and you want to model it, apply arch family of models. We will be talking about arch family of models. Let's open the file. Currencies I shared with you. I'm copying it and pasting it. I have not pasted it on my desktop. Open the data file currencies with eViews. Are you able to save the file with eViews? Are you able to save the file with eViews? No? Okay. Yes. First of all, we will be converting this value to return value. This is the basic value. We will be converting it to, or better, you open SNP hedge. SNP hedge, because these are the not SNP hedge. What was the CAPM? Sorry. Open the file CAPM. These are the share prices for different companies. Ford, GE, Microsoft, Oracle, S&P. Yes. We will be checking whether there is any arch effect or not. But for that, for arch family of models, our data should be stationary. For arch family of models, sorry, for arch family of models, our data should be stationary. So we will be checking whether our data is stationary or not. See, for stationary series, we may apply arch family of models. So first of all, we will be checking whether our data is stationary or not. Microsoft View Graph. It is not stationary. I am not going to check with the help of unit root test. I have already explained how to apply unit root test. I'm directly converting it to return RM. Return of Microsoft is equal to D log within bracket Microsoft bracket close into 100. Okay, yes, RM. I'm checking whether there is any outlier or not in the series. No outliers. Series is almost stationary. Clear? I'm going to apply arch effect I am going to check arch effect in the model. Estimate model RM space C. RM space C. I am regressing RM return of Microsoft on C. OK, and checking the residuals. View. Residual diagnostic, correlogram, Q-stat. Okay. Yes, no residual is significant. But for arch effect, we will be checking residual scare. For arch effect, we will be checking residual scare. Residual diagnostic, correlogram, scared residual. Okay. Yes. Third one is significant. Third lag is significant. It is significant or not? First is not significant, second is not significant, but third lag is significant. From where this correlogram has been arrived, we applied quick estimate equation, RM on C, then on residual view, residual diagnostic, correlogram, scaled residual, third lag is significant. We will be checking whether there is any arch effect or not. How many lags should we include in that test? Any from you? How many lags should we include? How many lags we should
then
include?
Three lags,
because third lag is important. It is crossing the upper bound. It may be crossing the lower bound, but it may be crossing the lower bound or upper bound. But if it is crossing the lower or upper bound, it is significant. So go to view, residual diagnostic, heteroscedasticity test. We want to check whether there is any arch effect or not. Whether there is any arch effect or not means heteroscedasticity is heteroscedasticity is conditional on its previous values or not. Means variance is conditional on its previous values or not. Point is clear or not? What is arch? What is arch? Autoregressive conditional heteroscedasticity means heteroscedasticity is conditional on its previous terms. Now my point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
It is clear. Very good. Arch means heteroscedasticity means variance. Variance is conditional. It is called heteroscedasticity because it is increasing with the increasing values. Yes. Null hypothesis for arch effect is no heteroscedasticity. What is null hypothesis? Null hypothesis is no heteroscedasticity, and null hypothesis has been rejected. It has been rejected or not? It has been rejected. Means there is arch effect, so we may apply arch model. Where to apply arch model? Change the method from least square to arch. Change the method from least square to arch. I am repeating. Estimate. Here is the equation. We apply it with the help of least square. Then method. Method should be arch. Arch order, garch order. What is arch and what is garch? What is AR and what is MA? Yes, now the beginners also know what is AR and what is MA. What is AR and what is MA? Yes. Anyone from you may reply. Yes, AR is AR means previous value of R, and MA means previous value of residual. MA means previous value of residual. Clear? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Same is arch and garch. Arch means it is the variance equation. This specification is for variance equation. This specification is for variance equation. This specification, this one is for mean equation. This one, in arch family of models, we are going to model mean as well as variance. This specification is for variance equation. Arch means squared residual of previous term. Because we are talking about variance, it is not only residual, it is squared residual. Arch means squared residual of previous lag, squared residual of lag 1. Clear? Clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Means arch is just like MA term. Arch is just like MA term. And garch means just like AR term. Because we are modeling what? We are modeling variance. Clear? We are modeling variance.
Ma'am.
And arch is residual, squared residual of previous lag. And garch is variance itself, but variance of previous lag. I think my point is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. It is one. It is one. Arch one, garch one. Arch one, garch one. Okay. This is the mean equation. Yes, see, it is, kya bolenge ise, 0.05. It is significant or not? It is significant or not? It is marginally significant. It will be called marginally significant. Clear? 0.0584.
Yes,
you can't reject the null hypothesis. It is not significant, but it is marginally significant. Yes. Then, residual minus 1 square. Arch term. Whether it is significant or not. No, it is not significant. Whereas garch term is significant. What does this mean? If arch term is significant, means there are spikes in the series. There are spikes in the series. If arch term is significant, there are spikes in the series. Means news impacts the any variation from the expected value impacts the variance. And in stock market, what is variance called? It is called volatility. It is called volatility. Markets are volatile or not volatile. Clear? So residual minus one square. If it is significant, it tells that there are spikes in the data. And what does garch minus one shows? If it is significant, means if there is a change in the volatility, it persists for a long time. Point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, let's check now again residual diagnostic. Correlogram Q-stat, not significant. Correlogram squared residuals, not significant. Earlier third was significant. Now it has been accounted for. no lag of scarred residual is significant. My point is clear. But I'm naming it with Microsoft GARCH. There is C, it is B. Symbol of C is B, means it is a vector. It is series, date series, Ford series, GE series, Microsoft series. This is equal to, means it is equation. We have saved the equation Microsoft GARCH. Now, let me check S&P, return of S&P. It was Microsoft, na? RM Microsoft. Yes, I'm going to generate RS, return of S is equal to D log S&P bracket close into 100. Again going to follow the same procedure, estimate equation R S space C. Okay, view residual diagnostic correlogram Q stat, same procedure, no, not important. View residual diagnostic correlogram scaled residuals, yes, first, third, fourth, these three lags are important. So while checking the arch effect, residual diagnostic heteroscedasticity arch, I'm including the term four lags. Okay, null hypothesis of no heteroscedasticity has been rejected, means we should apply arch model rather than linear models. Okay, now check view residual diagnostic correlogram. Yes, it has been accounted for. You may check for arch effect. There will be no arch effect now. Yes, now residual minus one square is important in this, means it is showing that there are more spikes. Let's compare these both equations. I'm naming it with S and P large. Yes. Now we have two equations, Microsoft GARCH, stat, and S&P GARCH. Let's compare these two. Variance equation. I'm comparing the variance equation. Yes. Residual minus one for Microsoft was 0.06 and it was not significant. Whereas residual minus one square is 0.24. For S&P and it is significant also, means which series has which value, which variable has more spikes than the other, which variable has more spikes than the other?
S&P GARCH.
S&P variable is return of S&P. That variable or its residuals have more spikes than the residuals of Microsoft. Means if there is any news, it impacts S&P, but it doesn't impact much to Microsoft. Point is clear? Next, GARCH minus 1. It is 0.8026. For this, it is 0.71026. Some authors compare this value GARCH minus 1, or some authors compare summation of these. For persistence, GARCH minus 1, it is 0.80 for Microsoft and 0.71 for S&P. Means if there is an impact in the system, then it persists more in case of Microsoft than in S&P. Clear or not? Clear or not?
Yes,
for
ma'am.
Spikes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, for ma'am. Spikes, let's save the residuals of both the equations. This equation is Microsoft. How to save the residuals in EVUs? Because residuals are sometimes very important to further work on. Procedure, make residual series. Ordinary, yes. Name this series. RES Microsoft. Okay. Residuals have been saved for the equation Microsoft. I'm crossing this equation. Yes, this equation is for S&P. Go to procedure, make residual series. Yes, name this. RES S&P. Okay. Let's compare these two residuals. I'm opening these residuals. These residuals together. RES Microsoft and RES S&P. View graph. Multiple graphs. Okay. Which one has spikes? S&P or Microsoft? Which one has spikes? Microsoft. S&P or Microsoft?
Sorry,
yes. S&P has S&P. More spikes.
Yes.
It has some spikes, some higher spikes, but it has less spikes. 1, 2, 3, 4. But it has many spikes. There is no case of rest in case of S&P. And persistence means close value, close values. It is in Microsoft. Clear? This is the difference between the two models. We may, it is not important to apply simply GARCH family of model on one of the series. It is always better to compare two variables for spikes as well as for persistence. My point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
It is clear. Yes. First model is, I'll be sharing my PPT with you on GARCH family of models. Yes. Next is, we have different type of models. Yes. Quick estimate equation. RM space C. Go to ARCH. What is ARCH? It is clear to all of you. What is ARCH? Why we are applying ARCH model? It is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
It is clear. Yes. If you are going to, let me check whether there is any message. If you are going to model the data of GDP, are you interested in volatility or not?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
why you are interested and why you are not interested for GDP. One of the participants said, yes, I am interested. One of the participants said, no, I am not interested. Why? Why you are interested and why you are not interested?
And because GDP is not sensitive to information.
GDP is not sensitive to information. So we are not interested in volatility in GDP. Yes, the participant who was interested.
But ma'am, changes in GDP can also influence the volatility in stock market.
Yes, but if you want to compare two countries, GDP of two countries, and you want to check whether there are spikes, because GDP is also dependent on international news. If two or more countries are more affected by international news, in that case, you may be interested in volatility of GDP. Clear? Otherwise, we are not interested in volatility of GDP. Yes, GDP has impact on stock market. We are interested in volatility of stock market, not the volatility of GDP. Clear? My point is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now, answer to the question that GDP impacts the stock market. And we are modeling the volatility of stock market. Then how to introduce this term? GDP impacts the volatility of stock market. And we are interested in stock market. Then how will you introduce GDP? In this model, in this window, where will you introduce GDP? Yes, if you have GDP data, where will you introduce this GDP? Yes. Any other? Yes. Here, variance regressors. Clear? The regressor, you want to, your literature suggests that this regressor impacts the volatility of this market. If it impacts the mean value, if it impacts the return, then we will be introducing here. For example, I say that return of Microsoft is impacted by return of S&P, because S&P is Index of America, just like Nifty and Sensex are indices of India, S&P is Index of America. Yes, because S&P is index and it may impact the, you know, the CAPM model. What is CAPM model? Any of you? Any of you? What is CAPM model? Capital asset pricing model.
Yes. Yes. Capital asset pricing model says that the price of any asset is determined by risk-free rate and the market premium.
Yes, market premium. Yes. How we model the CAPM? Excess return of a company is equal to C into excess return of indices. Clear? Excess return of market. That is capitalized asset pricing model or not? That is capital asset pricing model or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
We calculate the excess return. We regress the excess return of a company. Company shares on the excess return of that particular indices. Clear? Yes. Now, we may apply the S&P model here. Clear? We may apply S&P model here. In this case, it is 3 months data, US, B3, I'm assuming it is monthly data. Okay, how to regress this? It is annual data. This given, this data is given to annual data. I want to convert it to monthly return. I will be dividing it by 12. Clear? I'll be dividing it by 12. Or it is 3 months data. How to divide a variable by 12 in EBUs? How will you be, how will you dividing a variable by 12? Yes. It is advanced workshop and it is a simple question. Go to generate, give the new name to variable. You, it is treasury bill data, monthly, I'm giving the name, monthly treasury bill, TRB. Monthly treasury bill is equal to this USPB divided by 12. Simple. We will be getting a new variable, monthly treasury bill data. My point is clear or not? How to divide by 2, how to add 2, how to square it, how to square any variable. Just go to generate. If you convert any variable, just go to generate, write the new variable. Any variable is equal to old variable. It is, for example, 4. I want to square it. Raised to power 2. If you want to square root of it, SQRT within bracket, same, just like in Excel. Clear? Yes. Now, I'm going to apply CAPM, estimate equation, return of Microsoft is RM minus excess return. How the excess return is calculated? RM minus return risk-free rate, and risk-free rate is MONT monthly. Bracket close, it is the excess return of Microsoft is equal to, we don't write equal to, C space excess return of index value, RS minus monthly bill, MON, bracket close. Okay, it is the, what is this? What is this? This is beta. It is more than one, means Microsoft is more risky than
S&P.
Index.
S&P. Clear. Yes, there is arch effect. You will be getting the fourth value important. Then you may change the method to, sorry, go to estimate, change the method to arch. Yes. Okay. This is the effect. This is the equation. This is the value you want to interpret. Clear? These are the simple things. Yes. Now in arch, in arch model, I'm going for higher models. It was Microsoft arch. Go to estimate. This threshold order I am converting to 1. What does this mean? This threshold order I am converting to 1. What does it mean? What will it calculate? It will calculate, yes. Yes.
Ma'am, up to 1 lakh?
No. It will calculate whether positive and negative news have different impact. Whether positive and negative news have different impact on the volatility of Microsoft. Clear? It is called news impact. What does it called? It is called news impact. Whether positive and negative news have same asymmetry. It is called asymmetry. GJR model. Threshold, if we introduce one, two threshold, one or two threshold, that means it tells us about the news impact on the volatility. News impact means whether positive and negative news have same impact on volatility or not. Positive news means sales is increasing. Negative news means sales is decreasing. There was some negative news for Coca-Cola yesterday and day before yesterday. What was that?
About that football
player. What was
player?
That news? Yeah. No news. News nahi padte aap log.
There was some news. Haan ji. Footballer who, mom, there is a footballer who criticized the Coke, I think.
रोनाल्डो ने अपनी प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में कोका कोला की बोतल को साइड पर कर दिया था एकदम से उसके क्रैश हो गए थे शेयर्स इट वाज जस्ट लाइक नेगेटिव इंडिकेशन क्लियर पॉजिटिव इंडिकेशन कि पहले वहां लिम्का की बोतल्स होती थी अब वहां कोका कोला की बोतल्स हैं पॉजिटिव इंडिकेशन पहले वहां दो बोतल होती थी अब यहाँ तीन बोतल है या किसी ने रोनाल्डो को दिया कोका कोला की बोतल और रोनाल्डो ने बड़े खुश होकर पी ली इट इज पॉजिटिव न्यूज शेयर्स बढ़ते क्या एकदम शेयर इंक्रीज होते क्या एकदम नो बट नेगेटिव न्यूज से एकदम क्रैश हुए इट इज द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ पॉजिटिव मीन्स सेम लेवल की पॉजिटिव न्यूज और सेम लेवल की नेगेटिव न्यूज इक्वल इफेक्ट रखती है या नहीं रखती इट इज असिमेट्री व्हाट इज दिस इट इज असिमेट्री पॉइंट इज क्लियर और नॉट
Yes,
my point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Haan ji. Let's check whether positive and negative news have equal impact on volatility or not. Okay. Yes. This variable is not, this coefficient is not significant. Is it significant? No, it is not significant on the basis of p-value. This means positive and negative news have no asymmetry in impacting the volatility. Means those have same impact, whether news is positive or news is negative, it will have same impact. Point is clear, I think. Yes, let's check for S&P, same thing. For S&P, one. Now it is significant. Means positive and negative news have different impact on the volatility. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? It is positive means. Negative news impacts the volatility more than the positive news. Clear? But there is some problem. हाँ जी बताती हूँ फिर problem हम discuss करेंगे. Yes. This coefficient is positive and significant. It tells us that positive and negative news have different impact on volatility. Clear?
Yes,
clear?
Okay, ma'am.
See this. It is positive and significant means negative news impact. See, it is residual minus one is less than zero. Means if news is negative, see this portion. Residual minus 1 square into it has been multiplied when residual minus 1 square is less than 0. It has been multiplied by means they are it created a dummy variable for residual minus 1 square when it was negative. It was less than 0. Clear? When residual was negative, when residual was minus means negative news impacts volatility more than the positive news. Point is clear? But there is some problem in this equation. What is that problem? What is that problem? No coefficient should be negative. No coefficient should be negative, but there is negative coefficient, means there is some problem with the equation. We are going to, let's try to improve this. Yes. But now, yes, no issue. Clear? What does it mean? What does it mean? It means volatility is more impacted by negative news than the positive news. My point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
But ma'am,
yes. I'll be sharing with you PPT how to draw news impact curve. Steps I have given in that video, in that PPT. You may try those steps. Or I'll be preparing some video if there is time. Clear or not? Yes. Next is estimate. Okay. I'm going to estimate arch M, means arch value in mean. Whether variance impacts the mean or not. In this case, means there is a saying in commerce and management, higher risk, higher reward. Is or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Higher risk means variance. If variance is higher, whether return is higher or not. Whether variance impacts return or not. I have introduced variance in mean equation, arch M, mean equation. Okay. Yes. Let's see. No. It is not significant. Means with increasing or decreasing the volatility, return is not impacted. Clear? Return on S&P is same. I have opened the GARCH model of Microsoft and I want to check whether return of return of Microsoft impacts the volatility of return of S&P impacts the volatility of this or not. Yes, it has, but now go to estimate. Yes. Yes. Return of S&P impacts the volatility in Microsoft or not? Yes, it is impacting the volatility, means any variance regressor, any regressor you want to check, for example, GDP, if it is there, you may check whether it is impacting the volatility of this variable or not. Okay, yes, it is significant. Means it is impacting the volatility of model. I have one more file, macro. Sorry. I have one more file, macro. I shared with you this file or not? No. I'm opening this file with AViews. finish? No. There are macro variables, CPI, Microsoft, S&P, GDP is not there, money supply. We want to check whether volatility in Microsoft is impacted by money supply or not. How will be checking? Same method, just we will be introducing MI supply, money supply into, we will be introducing money supply into variance regressors. Quick estimate equation, arch, introduce here money supply. I think my point is clear. Our dependent variable should be stationary. No condition about independent variables. Our dependent variable should be stationary for applying the arch model, arch family. For variance regressor, no such condition is there. You will be able to model volatility with macro variables or not? With GDP, you may introduce so many variants you want to introduce. It is on the basis of literature, which regressors should be introduced here. Clear? Let's do the same thing with R. Yes, I have been transferred to Manesar. That is why I have changed this Government College for Girls Sector 14 to Government College for Girls Manesar. Yes. Let's revise. These are the steps. I'll be sharing this PPT with you. These are the steps. How to apply arch models with EVUs. Yes, diagnostics. We have checked QSTAT as well as squared residual. You may, after applying arch model, you may check for whether there is any arch effect in the residuals or not. You may again check the arch effect.
Ma'am?
Yes.
When we introduced RS term in our model, don't we introduce lagged values for that variable in the model?
When we introduce
RS variable in our previous model before introducing macro variables?
I'm not getting your question. Before introducing macro variables?
Yes, ma'am. The model which we will, you were discussing, you introduced RS term in the model. So I want to ask, we don't lagged values of it. Yes, yes, ma'am. RS lagged values.
Yes, see. Lag values of variance or lag values of mean?
The RS variable, ma'am, that you introduced.
AR values, lag values, or lag values in mean equation or variance equation? What do you want to introduce? Lagged values you may want to introduce in mean equation or variance equation?
I think it was introduced in variance equation.
Yes.
Variance regression.
Let me show you.
Ma'am.
Go to quick estimate equation. Arch. This arch one and arch one. What are these? These are the lagged values. Arch one means lagged value of residual or not? Let me do this for you. I'm directly calculating the return. Return space, see. Okay, see the results. What is this? Residual minus one square means first lag. Clear or not? This is the variance equation. This is the variance equation. Residual minus 1 square. Residual minus 1 is what? First leg. Large minus 1 means first leg. If we change this value from 1 to 2, means we have introduced 2 legs of emitter. See, residual minus 1 square, residual minus 2 square means we have introduced 2 legs of MA terms. If I change this guards to 2, means we have introduced 2 legs of guards terms. 2 legs of MA term means residual square, and 2 legs of AR term means guards. In the beginning, I told you that guards is just like in variance equation, guards is just like AR, and residual minus square or arch is just like MA. Clear? I think you are asking the same point. I have answered. I have responded to your question or not?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. You are asking this same question. You are asking this question or somewhat other thing you want to discuss?
No, ma'am. I got it, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Got it. Okay. Okay. Who is expert in R? Who is expert in R? I'm facing a little issue in R. Just a simple issue. Anyone? No one? Okay. Yes. We have a file SNPH. We have a file SNPH. Clear? We check the return. We calculated the return SR and FR. I'm facing the problem how to account for this NA. I'm not able to recall the command. Okay, I'll be checking for, though it should be applied on stationary data, but I'm applying it on non-stationary data because I'm confused how to account for this NA term. While writing the, for example, I'm going to regress SR on FR. I'm going to regress SR on FR. What is the command? LM within bracket. What is the command? Dependent variable, then independent variable or not? It is always better to give the model a name. Clear? Return is equal to linear model. Linear model, you apply SR on FR. First is write SR on FR and then give where is your data. Clear? Second method is, I'll be applying with both the method. Our data is in SNPH. Okay. It has applied it. Summary of what? My model name. My model name is return. Okay. It has not given this. Yes. It has given the summary of this data. Clear? Is it clear or not? It is simple model. It is clear or not? The second way.
Yes, ma'am.
The second way to write it. Return 1. I am giving my model name. Return 1 is equal to LM within bracket. Now, we don't want to follow this command SR on FR and data is an SNP. We want to directly write the name of independent and dependent variable. First is dependent and then independent. S and P. Dollar SNP. Dollar SR. Then same symbol. S and P. Dollar FR. This is return 1. Summary of return 1. Yes. Compare this. Summary is same. Means there are different methods of writing command in R. See, it is minimum is minus 2.4528. See, minimum is same. If you will compare the intercept value is 0.01307. Intercept value is same or not? There are two methods of writing the command. Clear? Now I want to save the residuals. Clear? I want to save the residuals of this equation. How to save the residuals? I'm saving in this file. S and P H. Yes, you will have to install one more package sandwich. S and P H and give the name. I'm giving the RES. Clear? Is equal to residuals of which, whether it is return 1 model or return 2, because both models are same. I have saved the, what is the problem? Error in data frame, template reserve, minus 3 value, replacement has 246. SNP residual is equal to residuals of return. Command should be right. Okay, let me see. S and P H. Give the name. I'm giving the name dice. Is equal to residuals. Residuals of return. This is the equation. I think it should be right. Don't know what is the problem, but I saved day before yesterday residuals. Let me check from here the is model 1. Okay. Summary SM view. Okay, you save the residual and then check whether there is any arch effect or not. Clear? Error in this data frame. S and P H then R E S is equal to residuals of, let me write the equation again, S and P H SR and S&P FR. Yes. Why it has not saved the residuals? S&P has residuals is equal to residuals. It has calculated, but didn't save in this package, in this data file. There is some issue. Let's do the same for some other variable. Yes, these are the variables. I saved the residuals. Maybe I have deleted the residuals. Maybe the problem. Let me save the residuals of the same in Crunchy's files. So these are the residuals I saved from the same variable, same equation, clear? These are the residuals named dyes, which I saved with the same equation. Now I'll be checking whether there is any arch effect in these residuals or not. It's not updating, it is calculating because it's not showing there is any problem, but it's not updating this file. Don't know why. It is so. So I'll be checking whether there is any arch effect in these residuals or not. With the name dyes, I have saved. Yes, maybe dyes was already there. Maybe the problem. Okay. For checking the arch effect, we have a package NARDL. Clear? In NARDL, it's not taking NARDL. There is arch test, clear? There is arch test for variable computes the Langrange multiplier test for conditional heteroscedasticity. See, it is showing us that it calculates the arch effect in the variable, arch effect. D mean. See, x means variable name, comma, lags, up to which lag you want to check, then d mean is equal to false. If you write this d mean is equal to false, means it will be checking the effect on the original value. And if you write d mean is equal to true, then it will be first demeaning it. Demeaning it means it will be regressing the variable on the C and then on the residuals, it will be checking the arch effect. But I have already saved the residuals. Clear? If you will be checking the arch effect on return of Microsoft, then you will demean is equal to true. My point is clear or not? My point is clear or not? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
My point is clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
To check the arch effect, the main package is NARDL. And under NARDL, there is arch test, which calculates the, which tests the conditional heteroscedasticity in the variable. You have to specify that variable, then lags, then d mean. D mean is equal to false, means it will not be regressing the variable on mean and calculating the arch effect on original series. And if you write d mean is equal to true, then it will be regressing the series on mean and will be calculating the arch effect on the residuals. I think my point is clear, but I already have residuals. It is in the file currencies, CURRR currencies, and variable name is nice, clear, comma, lags, how many lags, it is daily data. I am going to check arch effect for four lags, yes. Null hypothesis is no arch effect, clear, and on the basis of p-value, null hypothesis is rejected. Rejected or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, means there is arch effect in this variable. Clear? Clear? Then, for applying the GARCH model, we have to specify the model before writing the GARCH model. And it is the specification. Yes, give your model name. Clear? Model name, model 3, model 4, model 5, or any other name is equal to under RU GARCH package. Under RU GARCH package, you have U GARCH specification. You have to specify your model, U GARCH specification. Then you will be specifying your mean model and variance model. Mean model is equal to, it is same, is equal to list. ARMA order means whether you are going to introduce AR term or MA term or not. If it is 0, 0, means no AR term, we are only going to, yes, one thing. If you want to regress a series on C, what is the command? If you want to regress a series on a mean, what is the command? No. MODEL. I'm giving it this model, model number 6, is equal to LM, linear model, your series name, JPY. JPY is in currencies, CURRR currencies, JPY, regress it on one, means only one variable, and that variable is C. My point is clear or not? If you want to regress any variable on C constant, then command is this. Clear? Then summary of my model. My model is model 6. It is correct or not? Yes, it has given. See, this is the formula. This is minimum. Only intercept has been given. Clear? Clear? हाँ बोल दिया करो भाई, क्लियर हो तो ताकि मैं आगे चलूं. यस, हाउ टू रिग्रेस अ वेरिएबल ऑन कॉन्स्टेंट, कमांड इज lm, गिव योर डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल नेम, देन रिग्रेस इट ऑन वन. मीन्स ओनली वन कोफिशियंट वी वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट एंड दैट कोफिशियंट इज कॉन्स्टेंट. क्लियर? नाउ आर्च इफेक्ट वॉज देयर इन डाइस. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू अप्लाई Gauge model. For gauge model, first we have to specify our model. This is the specification. Model 4, or the name you want to give, is equal to under RU gauge package, there is specification. U gauge SPEC means we are going to specify our model. Mean model is equal to list within bracket ARMA order is equal to C00. If you will write C10, means you are introducing one AR in your mean model. If you write 01, means you are introducing one MA term in your mean model. If you write 11, means you are introducing one AR and one AM model in your one AR and one MA term in your mean model. Then variance model, list Gauge order. Gauge order is C11, means one gauge or one arch. Model is S-gauge. S-gauge means there are no variance regressors. I'm going to apply simple model. Clear? I'm copying this command. This was written by me earlier, but I'm changing the model name to model 7. Clear? Now, I'll be sharing with you this. Now, I want to apply this model on data I want to apply this model. This is the specification. Apply this model on which? I want to apply this on Francis and residuals. Nice. Clear? Means this is your model. This is your model. And this is your specification, your model. And this is means you want to apply this model on which data? Data is equal to currency 7. Apply model 7. I have specified model 7. Apply on it dice. It has given the results. Clear? It is simple AR1 MA1. This mu. This is the C in coefficient in mean equation. This omega, it is the constant of variance equation. Alpha, it is residual one square, means arch term. Beta, it is gauge term. Clear or not?
Yes,
clear,
ma'am.
Or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, this mu is, what is this mu? Mu is the constant in mean equation. Omega is constant in variance equation. Alpha 1, it is arch term, and beta 1, it is gauge term. Clear? On the basis of p-value, we may decide whether these are significant or not. constant in both the terms is not significant, but alpha is significant as well as beta is significant, means arch is significant as well as garch is significant. These are the information criteria for the same. You may change the specification according to your choice. If there will be one, means you will be introducing one arch, one AR and one MA. If this is, you will be listing garch 2, means you will be C11, garch, in garch order you write C21, means you will be introducing two AR terms and two arch terms and one garch terms. Clear or not? Higher order garch models with R we will be touching tomorrow or day after or on Monday. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. I have a question, ma'am.
Yes. Now it is time for queries. Let me, ma'am, stop sharing my screen.
Ma'am, yes. I want to ask that if I am applying garch model on some of these, on one of the data set, and even after I'm fulfilling all the assumptions, if I'm getting leg length as zero, what would have been done?
I'm not getting you. Leg length zero means which leg length you are getting zero? For applying arch garch model.
Yes, ma'am. For applying garch model.
Length in which?
Leg length is coming out as zero.
Which leg length? For arch effect?
No, ma'am. While calculating the garch model, we need to specify the equation for instance, I'm trying to apply the garch model on the returns of the gold prices. So I'm trying to specify the equation is gold prices, C, which is the constant term, and gold prices, gold returns minus that leg length, which I need to mention.
It is in mean equation.
It is in mean equation. So the leg length I want to mention there is coming out to as zero. What could be done for this?
Can you share your screen and show us that your results?
Okay, ma'am. Okay. We wait for a while.
Yeah. Share your screen and. Urvish ma'am, all are able to share their screen?
Yes, ma'am. All are able to share their screen.
Please pin the participant who is sharing the screen so that we will be able to see the screen. Yes, you have started sharing.
Yes, ma'am. Is it visible, ma'am?
Urushi, ma'am, I'm not able to see the screen. Who is sharing the screen? To whom? Is there option to pin? Yes,
okay, ma'am.
Please tell your name, ma'am, so that I may pin you. Your name?
Priyank, ma'am. Priyank Kulshrest.
How is it visible?
Visible.
Yes, now it is visible.
So,
yes.
These are what my returns are.
Okay. You are doing on gold data.
Yes, I am doing on gold data for 5 years.
My thesis is on metals.
Okay, ma'am. So these are the gold returns. Returns first difference for 5 years of gold data.
Okay.
Now for that, when I'm going to go for correlogram,
yes,
it is giving me the normality. It is telling me that there is no out of bound. It is telling me that it is no out of bound. No out of bound correlations. No extra correlation.
Yes,
it is within
no
bounds.
Autocorrelation.
There is no autocorrelation. No.
Quick.
Yes, ma'am. I'm
go
going
to
quick.
Yes. Estimate equation.
Ji, ma'am.
Write your variable name and address on C.
Should I go for it?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And then again, I'm going residual diagnostic.
Yes.
Legs to include. Again,
okay.
there are no indications for leg length.
Yeah, real. Means it is not correlated. It is not autocorrelated. Now see, view. Where is your equation window? It is. Yes, yes. You are on equation window. View, residual diagnostic. Correlogram squared residual. Next option. Yes. Means there is no arch effect even. Your data is correct?
Yes,
data
ma'am.
Data is from?
From 2015 to 2020. Daily data.
Okay. Okay, you have collected this data from?
I don't remember the site because I collected much earlier. So I don't remember the site from where I
No issue. You may report that there is no even arch effect. These are not autoregressive, means we can't forecast it on the basis of its previous value. We have to introduce no arch effect. Squared residual is showing no arch effect.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. It's a good indication that it is stable now, not so much volatile. Clear? But if you will be taking the data for COVID time, for the last year, you will get, you will check it is very much volatile. It will be very much volatile.
So the year 2020 has been in the sample period, no? From 2015 to 2020, year 2020 was in sample period. So there has to be some arch effect.
Show me the graph of prices.
Okay.
Original prices, note
okay,
of return
okay.
series.
Okay,
yeah.
Ma'am. Okay.
You may name this series. Yes.
These are my spot prices and
okay. Graph, line and symbol.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. See, it has changed the behavior from 2020. The behavior has been changed.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
You may introduce dummy variable assuming it a structural change. Clear? If you introduce a dummy variable for this period, how to introduce dummy variable for breakpoint, I have mentioned in my file, I have shared with you important points. I shared with you that file. Yes, introduce the dummy and then go to a quick estimate equation, your series name, space C and then then this dummy variable name. Then check whether the behavior has been changed or not. Clear?
Okay. Ma'am, can I add regressors as well?
Can I add? Okay.
That point of the exogenous variable can be added?
Yeah, you may add exogenous variable.
In variance,
market price, this may be Nifty,
maybe Sensex, COVID data,
maybe Nifty, but it should be supported by literature. Clear?
Okay.
You may introduce any exogenous variable, but that should be supported by your literature. It is better always to introduce the exogenous variable. Clear?
But on the whole, I can say that my gold prices don't show any arch effect.
No, it is a good observation. it is a good observation that there are no artifacts in your data. There is no autocorrelation as well as artifact. I doubt that this data is for Delhi.
The data is for Delhi. I have 1403 observation over the period of 5 years.
Okay, let me show you my data for Delhi prices. Let you stop sharing and let me show my screen. I didn't share with you that data file. I have data file for Delhi. Data is matched. Let me search the data in my laptop and then show you the Delhi data. Yes, I'm showing you. Yes, I'm sharing my screen. My screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Yes, it is port data for, I think it is for Nifty. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Who is Lalit Pandey? I don't know. It is Nifty data. 15 December 2003, 16 December 2003, 17 December 2003, 18 December, 19 December. Then there was Saturday, Sunday.
Yes.
Your data, that is not. View, graph, if I want to present it graphically, line and symbol, it shows me connect adjacent. Because there are days which were not trading days. It was not showing for you.
Let me see.
Now you open the file by sharing the screen. I tell you what is the problem.
Share
the screen and open the file from the very beginning. Open the file with eViews. Any other query, or I have to solve this only this query? No. Open the file with eViews from the starting.
Okay.
Cross this file. Because your X variable X-axis is not showing the date.
These are the dates.
Cross this file. First, second, fifth. These are dates.
Yes, ma'am.
But dates are, you have not imported dates as dates.
Is it okay, ma'am?
Yeah, now it is okay. Yeah, now it will be showing your, now it will be showing your graph by plotting on X. Now show graph. Graph. No, you have opened two as a group. No.
Yes.
That is not okay. No.
Okay.
You have not imported the date as date.
Okay, ma'am.